Okay, guys, welcome back to the channel. We are up on Ski Mountain. It's a nasty old rainy day, and I know you guys are excited to get out, get soaking wet with us. The camera's gonna get water all up in the speaker hole. Get water in your speaker hole, you won't be able to hear me.
Oh, there they are.
Be all fogged up on the lens.
It's gonna be great.
It'll be fantastic.
This thing needs like its own little umbrella or something.
He put that 500, that Ford 500 right in there.
Boy, there's like no room either, is there? There they are.
Turn right on the North Camino Drive.
Okay, Siri, we got it.
Go play in the water. Hey guys. Hey, doing good. How are you? You were good until that happened, right?
Yeah. Just until then.
You guys just now getting here?
We've been here for a couple days. I missed my turn. We live up there, but it was raining and I was paying attention to the road and went up here.
Yeah.
Popped in reverse, I think a little bit too fast, my car stalled out. And I started rolling back down.
Slid back down. Yeah. Well, it looks like you tried with some sticks.
Oh, we tried.
We surely tried.
You surely tried, huh? Maybe it won't be too bad. We'll get some stuff hooked up.
Yeah.
Okay. Got him out.
Hey guys, welcome back to the channel. Super late. Just picked up that motorcycle, that Harley, up in the national park. Then we got another PD call for somebody up here. Ski Mountain, again, stuck. Ran off the road. Not seeing any lights yet, but gotta be close. There we are.
Oh, there.
Your destination is on the left.
In there. Oh my goodness, there's one tire on the road. You need to get turned around. You found someone in the ditch, huh?
Yeah. All right. It happened Tuesday as well.
Oh my gosh. It happens every day. Are they okay?
Yeah.
Okay. Hello. Y'all all right? Okay. He's going to get turned around. He'll come. He'll probably set up probably about right where you are.
Okay, I'll pull down to the other side.
Awesome. Thank you. He's going to pull down past us. Oh. Guess not. All right. Yeah, you're right.
Good, how you doing?
So were you backing up or?
We're going to a cabin I rented.
Yeah?
Nice, it's been off.
Yeah, once you get one wheel off, that's it, you're pretty much done.
Yeah, that guy's fun. That's all I got to say. That guy's fun.
He said it wasn't his first time he pulled him out. So.
Man, he was going crazy on that last one. He was talking to his brother on the phone or something. It was hilarious. He got ready to hang up and he said, "All right, well, I love you." And he said something about, "Now that's my brother, huh?"
I can't get through that.
Yeah, I'm going.
Thank you.
right beside it.
A pretty good sized ditch. I don't know what you say that is, three and a half. You climbed out of there, what was it, 3.5 feet?
Yeah.
Is that something of yours? If it is, I'll grab it.
Anything?
I don't know what that might be.
I don't know what that is.
Didn't tell you.
Hubcap.
Is it really?
You're probably missing a hubcap on that side.
It'll be all right.
You don't want it back?
No.
Okay. All right. Yeah, I can see. So did you go in way back there? Around the corner? That makes sense. Yeah. Well, I'm glad y'all are okay. You should be able to be on your way. I will get you a ticket going. Is there damage over here? It is your hubcap. Yeah, you might need to hit a car wash.
I don't know. That one was already gone.
Oh, was it really? Okay. So it wasn't your hubcap. But yeah, you might want to hit up a car wash just to spray some of this dirt out of your brakes. But aside from that, I think you're fine. All right. Good deal.
Hi, YouTube. Kristen's driving.
I'm gonna charge now.
Better look out. Coming to get you, spot 26.
Okay, we can swap.
I don't want to.
I'm backing into it.
Oh. Guess who's back? Back again. Jeffrey's back. Tell your friends.
Goodness. Listen, I'm going to need a tripod. Like, you didn't do a very good job as a passenger because I don't have a tripod ready.
Do nothing. I do what I want.
Yeah, we know.
Spot 26.
It's an easy one, isn't it? Maybe I should have practiced on spot 26. I'm
telling you. You got right in here. Looked up this full-size truck.
No. That's all you, bud. What's this? Hooked up towing over here. Yeah, over here. He says get hooked. Something went weird with the camera. Okay.
Huh?
Something went weird with the camera. It did something weird. Probably. What's back here?
Big park.
It says something on there, but I can't read that.
stuff on wheels.
Imagine that. Scuffs. Do you need dollies?
No, shit.
All right.
But imagine if
you drive
55-inch wheel. I'm trying to wrap this.
Yeah, it's kind of big, isn't it? Doing good. Spot with a six. They are there.
Oh yeah. Some slight damage here in the rear region.
Wheel there. Spot 27.
It's missing the valve stem cap.
There's the sign. Okay. I'll make note of that. Scratches on the door, on the door handle. Huh. No hotel hang tag. Bumper. See, fit is not exact. So, what a nice move. This crack there. Bumper doesn't line up perfectly there. No hotel hang tag in this one.
Can I borrow that?
Yeah.
Thanks. Rear wheel drive.
Not all wheel?
Not all wheel.
Okay, it's got some cracks in that front bumper. It does not have hang tag. So that's interesting. There.
It's getting busy.
Too much here.
Yeah. Park here.
We better get out of here.
Yeah.
All right. We should go. Hopefully these wheels stay straight too.
That would be nice. Surely it doesn't happen twice though. Gallenberg.
Don't blind him. Okay. Well, we're not being chased. I'll write down this tag. Call them in.
Everything auto.
You guys towed my truck.
What kind of truck?
Can you give me a location where you're on that so I can go pick it up?
What kind of truck you got?
It's a Chevrolet 1500. It's a lowered one.
Yes, sir. It's parked in the numbered spots in Gatlinburg. Yes, sir.
It's in Pigeon Forge?
No, sir. It's in our impound lot in Gatlinburg.
How far is it from that hotel, from this hotel over here?
You're probably 15, 20 minutes.
Can you send me the address, please, to this phone number?
I can, but there's not going to be anybody at the lot, man. It's 4 o'clock in the morning. I can. There's not going to be anybody at the lot. It's 4 o'clock in the morning.
You know what time you guys open?
It'll be Monday at 8 o'clock for the pickup.
Monday at 8 o'clock?
Yes, sir. It is Sunday, 4 a.m. right now.
So there's nobody gonna be over there tomorrow.
Not on Sunday.
Oh shit! All right.
You're gonna call me and text me and call me.
Hello.
Hey, this is Jeff, Everything Auto. Missed your call.
Hey, what time do you guys open?
What you needing?
I need to go pick up a truck today.
For pickups, we do Monday through Friday, 8 to 5.
Alright, what if, there's no way y'all can do it if it's an emergency?
But I definitely can't do it at 4 o'clock in the morning, no.
Well, no, not at 4 in the morning, of course not, but, you know, later.
I mean, yeah, we could possibly get somebody over at the gate, but yeah, it's not going to be anywhere near 4 o'clock in the morning, no.
No, of course not. Okay, so what time around is fine for me to call back and then y'all can get somebody to the gate?
You might try us back around 10 or 11.
10 or 11?
Yes.
Okay.
All right, thank you.
In the morning, right? Yeah.
Yes, thank you.
Okay, thank you.
They have been calling and texting and calling and texting. It's 4 o'clock in the morning. No.
Everything Auto?
Hi, how are you?
How you doing?
I'm looking to pick up my truck today.
Okay, yeah, probably going to be, should have somebody over at the lot about 30 minutes.
In 30 minutes?
Yes.
Okay, thank you.
Thank you. Okay, on schedule, I guess, guys. They kind of upset me a little bit last night, and I try not to get in that zone. But you know, we worked a pretty crazy long shift there, and they were calling me at 4 o'clock in the morning, demanding their car back. Well, it was in a text, I guess. Dude, I need my car, and you know, it just kind of got me a little bit. So I told them that the 8 to 5 Monday through Friday on pickups, and I'm usually not there. I'm usually, we'll do whatever, but I'm not going to, I mean, 3 or 4 o'clock in the morning, I'm just not going to do. I've done some 12, 1 o'clock in the mornings for pickups, and that's, you know, that's just crazy. That's just crazy. We shouldn't have to be out doing office pickups and things like that at those hours. But anyway, it is Sunday, and I'm headed over to the lot just because I told them that I would. It is about the 10 o'clock hour. So, much better for me in being awake. But we're going to head over there, guys, and see if we can get them their truck back. We do have another one on the lot that I haven't heard from. So, maybe we'll get both of them done at once. Stick around.
hello?
Hey, this is Jeff again, Everything Auto. Hey, I wanted to make sure you got my text. For the pickup of the truck, the ID has to match the registration for the release. So I can only release it to the registered owner.
Okay,
Does the registration...
I have no idea. I've not... all we do is run the plates through the police department. We don't... I have no idea who the registered owner is. So if the registration in the vehicle reflects one of you guys on there, then I can release it to you.
Okay, can we... I'm sorry. Can the guy that's going over there towards tow truck, can we meet in an hour? Because the problem is right now, we can't find an Uber for some reason. And that's the problem right now.
Okay.
Is that okay?
Yeah, that's fine. I'll meet you over there in about an hour then.
Okay. Thank you.
Thank you. And I don't... Were they going to get an Uber at 4 a.m. when they were trying to call me demanding their truck? I don't... Maybe it would have been easier at 4 a.m. I don't know. There's a couple of things that I like in life. One is sleeping, and two is food. And this job is very hard to do both of those.
Everything auto.
Is there anybody at your shop right now?
Yes.
They'd be there in about 20 minutes. I'll be there in about 20.
Okay, we'll have somebody here.
Thank you, man.
Thank you.
Six.
Everything auto?
Hi. I am assuming that I got towed outside my hotel. I guess I just need details on that.
Was it the Chrysler?
I'm so sorry. Get out of my face. I'm so sorry.
Okay.
Yeah. So I came to the hotel and they said the front, and then they said, like, he hand motioned the front, and then he said parking on the side. He didn't specify. So apparently I parked in a numbered spot. I'm not from here, so I had no idea.
Yes, ma'am. Yeah, as long as you're the registered owner, ID matches the registration of the vehicle, we can release it to you. We cash, we can't do card on.
Oh, my God.
Illegal.
He didn't specify that I can't. There's, like, nothing that I can do?
That's just the cost for the tow away from late last night. Yes, ma'am.
Here's the thing, though. That is the side of the building, though. It should have been specified, not the number of parking. It's the front and the side. So, now that I'm speaking with you, would you consider that the side of the building of the hotel?
Well, ma'am,
where it was picked up from?
There's the numbered spots, and then there's signage.
Right. If someone's like, I'm just asking you just having a conversation with you. If someone said the side of the front and the side, would you, if they didn't specify that it wasn't numbered parking, would you think that that was the side of the building if you're not from around here?
Well, I mean, if there was ever any question, I would have went back and asked. You know, it's the numbered spots and the signage should have been a pretty good giveaway of maybe I should either ask a question or maybe I shouldn't park here. I don't know what else to say. I mean, there's lots of signs and they do not have numbered spots.
Okay. All right. All right, I'll call back.
Okay, thank you.
All right.
And of course they would be at the wrong place.
Hey, I'm outside your shop, man.
You're not outside impound lot, no. Because I'm sitting here waiting on you.
impound lot.
It's 221 Newman Road in Gatlinburg. That's the address that I give you. Yeah, that's the address that I'd given you.
Oh my God! Why does it say something else on your 221. What'd you say it was?
Newman Road.
Newman. Oh wow! All right.
Oh, this guy, man, I'm telling you, if he'd just pay attention to me instead of wanting to call and be, I don't even know, guys. I don't even know. Anyway, I've been sitting here now that he's demanded to pick up his car, and I've been sitting over here at the gate waiting on him for an hour and a half after I finally agreed to come over here and meet him at 10:30 or 11, and then he doesn't pay any attention to the address, and he's at the wrong location. So, my goodness. Everything auto?
Hello. If I pay to get my car, how do I go to come get it?
It's 221 Newman Road in Gatlinburg.
Okay, so then I would have to, like, Uber to that. I'm sorry. Did I just speak with you?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay, so I have to...
Yes, ma'am. As long as your ID matches the registration. As long as your ID matches the registration.
I'm sorry, what did you say?
Yes, ma'am. As long as your ID matches the registration, I can release it back to you, but you have to be the registered owner of the vehicle, and...
I am. Okay. I am. What's the address?
221 Newman Road.
What time was it, Toad?
Let me see. It was 10:30 last night.
And what time what are the hours of that parking area?
That parking area is for employees only. And there's no hours.
Employees for the hotel?
No, ma'am. The employees for that will work in and around Gatlinburg. Those spots are paid for and rented, so employees that work in and around Gatlinburg have a place to park. And so when security comes around and you don't have a employee hang tag, then they know that you're not supposed to be there.
Okay. Thank you.
Thank you. Hey, buddy.
How are you doing?
And you're the registered owner of the vehicle?
Partly.
You mean?
My dad's on the registration.
But your name is on it too?
I'm pretty sure it is, yeah.
Okay. And if you got the keys, I'll bring it up here to you.
Can I go with you? I got kind of some personal stuff in the truck.
Insurance just doesn't allow me to have you drive it on the lot, so let me give you that back. Personal stuff, that's what he means. rude, boss. Yeah, if I could just see the registration to make sure your name is on that. There's your keys back. Wrong spot, brother. Wrong spot.
I'm gonna spin my ass home.
Yeah, man. Any of those numbered spots over there are kind of a bad. Did the hotel not tell you that you couldn't park there?
Nah, there was a couple cars parked in front of that sign, so I didn't get to see it.
Gotcha. All righty, man. Sorry. Hope you have a better trip.
I hope so too.
Hello.
Hey, this is Jeff, Everything Auto.
Hey.
Hey, I'm just making sure I don't miss you here. We're not normally at the lot on Sundays, and I didn't know if you were headed this way or.
Oh gosh, yeah, I'm waiting on an Uber right now. It's saying that it's looking for an Uber nearby me. I'm at the you know where I'm at because you took my car, but it's,
yes, ma'am.
Okay.
Well, if you don't care, just give me a text or a call about 30 minutes before. That way, we make sure we've got somebody here. Like I said, because we don't normally have people here on Sundays.
It says, I mean, it's saying that I should be dropped off by 1:15, but like, I don't know. I'm from Ohio. I don't really. I'm sorry.
No, you're okay.
I'm sure you probably get this a lot.
Yeah, we're just just like I said, we don't have anybody here. We just want to make sure we don't miss you. I don't want you here waiting on me, you know.
I mean, well, if I'm there waiting, that's the least of my worries. Okay. You know.
Okay.
I don't know. And if I was grouchy earlier, it was just because the people at the hotel were not very kind to me. So.
No, I completely understand.
They played a recording, like the recording of when I checked in, and he said the front of the building and the side of the building. So that's what I assume. Mm-hmm. You know, like.
Yes, ma'am.
So. I didn't look at the signs that were there. I mean,
yes, ma'am.
Ma'am. So they just weren't very kind to me. So
yes, ma'am. Well, I'm sorry. I'm sorry to hear that. That's
yeah.
That's not. I mean,
it's not your fault. I mean, I just expected not to be doing this one.
This is definitely not. It's definitely not part of the agenda for vacation. I'm sure of it. But
well, yeah, because that's what I was saying. I was like, so what if that was my gas money to get back home? Like I. You know, I mean, and I get, like, it was my error, but, again, like, they should have been a little bit more empathetic to the situation, yeah. I feel like, or helped me find a ride or get an Uber or whatever the case may be, because I didn't even have the Uber app on my phone.
Yeah,
so,
yeah.
And now it's changing the time again, so, I mean, I guess I can,
Yeah, just let me know. Like I said, normally they'll give you a call when they've got somebody scheduled or something like that. And as long as I know, I can be back over here at the lot in about 30 minutes. I just don't, you know, I don't want to put you guys out. I know you need your car and it's vacation and all that good stuff. So, but we want to make sure we've got somebody here for you.
Okay, and you said just call or text.
You can call or text this number. It's fine either way. And yeah, just give me about 30 minutes.
Okay. Do you recommend, aside from Uber, do you recommend anything else?
We use like Benz Taxi quite a bit. They're pretty awesome for this area. Benz Taxi.
And is it a number that I just call?
Yeah, it's just a cab service. Let me see if I can find.
You might give me a phone number, so let me know.
Yeah. Benz Taxi. If you've got something to write with, I can give you that number.
Yep. Go ahead.
It's 865.
865.
484.
484
4939
4939
And he knows we're over here in 221 Newman Road. He knows where we're at, and he helps us out a lot with roadside stuff too, so.
Okay. All right. Well, I'll call them, and then can I call you right back, so then if they're going to be here within like a few minutes?
Yeah, that'll be fine.
Okay. Okay. All righty, thank you.
Thank you, ma'am.
Thanks, bye.
Bye-bye. Oh, Chef?
Hello, it's Ashley. I think I just spoke with you.
Yes, ma'am.
They said they'll be here in 10 minutes.
Okay, perfect. I'll see you guys here.
All right, perfect. Thank you so much.
Thank you. Bye-bye.
Thanks, bye-bye.
The gal is here to pick up her car, so
let's go see if we can make this happen. Hi guys.
Oh my goodness,
that's the one back there, huh?
Yeah.
So, did you get anything figured out from the? You said the hotel was showing you a surveillance or something.
They were listening to like the recorded conversation, and when I was there at the front desk, he said you can park in the front, and he said you can park on the side of the building. To me, if I'm not from here, you know, I was originally parked in between big, huge trucks. I didn't see anything.
Yeah.
And I seen other cars that had little hanging things, and I didn't see anything. He's like, well, it's not my fault that you interpreted it that way. I said, that to me, that's the side of the building. He should have said the side of the building, aside from the numbered parking.
From the numbered spots. Yeah, that's what he should be telling people.
Yeah, no, no.
Literally. Because they went through too, and they put their logo in the parking spots as well. I don't know if he mentioned.
No.
He didn't know.
No.
Yeah, they painted their logos on there, and then
the logos for the
hotel.
No, they did not mention any of that. No.
Any of what?
Nope. That they put logos on every single parking to specify. No.
Nothing.
They were like, well, they said no parking across the street. But to me, when we're talking this way and he says across the street, I'm thinking
in front of the building.
Across the street. I'm not thinking.
Yeah.
To me, that's not even a street because I'm not from here.
Yeah. Yeah.
It's, I'm like,
it's a tough situation. As you can see, they called us for another one right when you're.
I know. I'm like, damn.
I mean, it's.
But that's the thing, though. I said, you guys need to specify. He was like, well, then you should have asked questions. I said, if you listen to the recording, I did ask questions. And I also said, so if there's no parking here, I come back to you. And then you guys will tell me about parking that's a block away. I said, it's a block away. And
he's
like, yes. And I'm like, okay. So to me, I'm asking questions. I'm sorry that I'm just.
Yeah, and I mean, it's simple. You know, it's don't park in the numbered spots. That's all
they had to say.
And that would have stuck in your mind.
Hey,
I
have done that. Yeah. Because she had to get out because I couldn't see any. Because she was like helping me park.
Yeah.
But, and I parked between two big trucks. So the signs that were there, I didn't see until I just was out there looking like, damn, like.
Yeah.
You can see those spots.
Yeah, it's crazy over there. The.
I was like, is he coming back? I know my card went through.
Yeah, no, they're. Yeah, they're good. Well, I hate that for you guys. Like I said, they just call us to do a thing. And,
I know it's not. If anything, I'm more so disappointed in the fact of how they even handled the situation, and the fact that I'm stuck there. You know, it's like and just the fact that they're getting my money. They just left me just like, oh well, here's a number, figure it out. No, I mean a number to a taxi service. Like, how am I supposed to get there? Mo and Joe's not going to get me there very quick.
Yeah, and we try to give everybody, you know, Ubers and Lyfts. Sometimes they get crazy in this area, and we try to keep a running list of taxis and things like that. So that's kind of crazy for them not to at least reach out and try to help you.
Did not. He literally didn't want, because the thing was, is that he said, well, he said the way that he said it, the wording was wrong.
Yeah.
Then he said, I misinterpreted it. And I said, well, you just said the way he said it wasn't, he didn't specify.
Yeah.
But now that the finger can be pointed at you and you could be held, now you don't want to talk about it anymore.
Yeah. It would be nice to.
Yeah, but like I told him, I said, okay, but if you hear him say, like, don't park across the street, you're not seeing his hand gestures when he literally is saying across the street.
Across the street. No, I get you. I do. If somebody told me across the street, I would think it would be in front of the building across the street. That's what I would.
Across the street to me, when he's standing here and he's like across the street, I'm not going to think.
Yeah.
I mean, I guess it is across the street, but it was the hand gestures for me.
Yeah, and it is. I mean, you're excited. You're on vacation. You're here to have some fun. You're not here to to really get into the.
And that's why I said I and I was like, and he was like, well, it's not my fault the way you interpreted it. I said, but I did ask questions about parking though.
Yeah.
So if you can hear me asking questions,
yeah,
you couldn't be like, hey, you know what, that is true, but it could be this much of where I was wrong in the whole situation.
Yeah.
They're not paying that money.
Yeah. Yeah. It's unfortunate. It really is. But yeah, just know that. I mean, just, Gatlinburg's pretty good about numbering their spots. So if I seen that, I would steer clear of any of that stuff.
Any number of parking.
Yeah. The signage, they put a bunch of signage. They had a bunch of problems with big box trucks coming in. They've even called me for semis that have pulled in there to do deliveries and then blocked 6 employees from coming to work. So it's a bad spot.
Yeah.
It's a bad spot. But you got keys? I'll go get your...
Yeah.
I'll bring it over here for you. Insurance gets crazy on me when I got people driving around on my parking lot. Sorry.
Oh, no, you're fine.
I'll go get it for you.
Why smell like puke in there?
Oh. No, it really might. My son, we drove for 6 hours, and apparently he gets car sick.
Hey, I do too.
So he literally, like, she was in the middle, and he started vomiting everywhere. So
yeah.
Now we have to scrub the car seat. So if you smell anything.
No, you're fine. You're fine. That happens too, for sure. Oh, I look forward to this. Unlocked too last night.
Well, I mean,
I locked it back.
There was, of course, it's
here.
In there.
It's here on our lot, but yeah, I just it was unlocked too.
Okay.
But I left the keys in the console there, and